you just purchased or received a beautiful plant for your garden. With care, it was planted, and in just a few days, it's looking sad. We often hear these calls for help. Let's look at what could possibly go wrong in what seems like just overnight. Hi, I'm Lorna, a University of Missouri Extension Master Gardener of Greater Kansas City. Today's Tuesday tip, we'll take a look at transplant shock and if this could be the cause of your plant woes. Shock can happen with any plant, whether the plant is transplanted from one container to another, from a container into the ground, maybe you're planting a large tree or digging and dividing perennials. No matter how careful you are, uprooting and replanting will cause a disturbance to the plant's root system. Depending on the severity of the disturbance, this can be very stressful for a plant as it loses some of its ability to absorb vital nutrients and water. As a result of that stress, the plant goes into survival mode and suffers what's known to us as transplant shock. Transplant shock delays the plant's ability to establish itself in its new environment. Factors such as differences in soil composition, moisture levels, and the weather, with temperature fluctuations, sunlight, wind, and rain, can also play a role in transplant shock. How do you know if what you are experiencing with your plant is transplant shock? Unfortunately, a wide range of symptoms can be attributed to transplant shock. Your leaves may brown and crisp on the edges. Your leaves may wilt or look droopy, look as if they've been scorched, or they may curl or yellow. Transplanted or new trees can seem to have a sparse canopy, or they might be late to leaf out the following spring. Blooms may slow down, or the reduced growth might be less than you expected. You might even experience dead branches on shrubs or on trees that you have planted. You see these symptoms, and no doubt you experience some transplant shock yourself. Go easy on yourself. It's almost impossible to avoid some transplant stress. Do the best for your plants from the start by buying the very best plants you can find. Avoid any that show obvious signs of pests, disease, or obvious damage. Remember the gardening mantra, right plant, right place. Choose plants that are well suited to their location. Whether a new-to-you plant or you're transplanting an existing plant, check the plant labels or do some research to make sure you're giving that plant the best environment. When planting, whether it's a big container shrub or a tree, or a bald and burlapped plant, maybe bare root or a pack of annuals or a pot perennial, protect those roots at all costs. Roots are vital to the plant's well-being, especially the tiny roots at the very ends of their clumps. Disturb the roots as little as possible. Don't shake the dirt off, bump the root ball, or rough up those roots. Of course, if you're dividing an overgrown perennial clump, root disturbance is unavoidable. But get as much of the root ball as possible. The more roots you keep, the better the chance for surviving for the plant. Never allow that root ball to dry out. Make sure it's well watered before you plant it, and again after you plant, even if you think it may rain. Water the new site well the days before the transplant so that moisture will permeate the area and make the conditions as perfect as possible. Carefully spread the roots out when you're planting the plant. You often see container-grown roots circling the inside of the bottom of the pot. If so, you need to gently loosen or tease those roots out of that circling shape. Make your transplant hole plenty big and score or rough up the sides of the hole so that the roots can more easily grow into that soil. Don't plant your trees too deep. Trees need their root flare at or slightly above the soil line. Avoid planting in the hot, scorching sun. Instead, plant in the early morning, the evening, or on an overcast day like today. And if you have a particularly windy site, you might want to protect your new plants from that wind by constructing a temporary windbreak. Keep your new transplants well watered, but not overwatered, which is always a little tricky. Plants need good drainage. Now, how will you tell when your plant has successfully taken root? Your plant's leaves look normal. They're not wilty, curled, or stressed, or discolored. You might see new growth or buds. This is time to return to normal care. To fertilize or not to fertilize, or that's the question, still debated by professionals. Some say nothing should be added for the first year. Others say you can start fertilizing immediately by adding a root stimulator at planting time. We're here to say too much nitrogen can burn the roots or stimulate more top growth than those roots can support. Your very best practice are the ones we just discussed. Right plant for the right site, plant it right, water it right, protect it right. And as a side note, a soil test may be of value to see exactly what's going on with your soil before you begin. Be patient. Some plants recover within a couple of weeks, but other larger specimens may take 5 years to become well established. We hope you've enjoyed today's Tuesday tip. If you like our videos, be sure to give us a thumbs up. Check for the MU Extension guide sheets and our resources in the Show More section below. See you in the garden!